What's going on, everybody? It's your boy C4 here today, bringing you a highly requested, highly fun, makes absolutely no fucking sense, one-off connected franchise mode. As always, I will start this video up before we even jump in. You can tell from the title what it is. Leave me comments in the comment section below of suggestions of connected franchise modes that I can do in the coming. Just one-offs. These are going to be, you know, you guys seeing this. I should be able to start live streaming soon. And while I am going to be finishing off the college legendary rosters with some live streams, also these one-off connected franchise modes are fairly enjoyable for me to do. So the more creative ideas, the better. I have a couple that are upcoming. I'm doing one that I'm going to call, let's see actually what I got here, officially. There's no rush on this video as it's going to be probably kind of long. So I have, I'm going to be doing maybe potential career rebuild videos, where just like maybe I do like a Tim Tebow, see what happens, do like a quick like, I don't know how exactly a format be, maybe 3, 4, 5 years with Tim Tebow, Jamarcus Russell, Johnny Manziel, Christian Ponder, Jake Locker, I got Trent Richardson, Javid Best, Reggie Bush, Justin Blackman, maybe do position switches, Julian Edelman, Terrell Pryor, Braxton Miller, Ryan Tannehill, Richard Sherman. Making, you know, most of those guys quarterbacks, some of the wide receivers, stuff like that. Maybe players that you would want to see me maybe do a rebuild of, I could do that. We also have, I'm going to do one closer to the draft, which will be a C4 mock draft history team. So I'm going to look at how my Philadelphia Eagles mock draft all the way back to 2012 that I've done would look on the current Eagles roster. I think that will be pretty cool. We're going to finish up after we're done all the legendary college roster videos with an all-time college roster connected franchise mode. Today is going to be what you're seeing. I'm also going to do a day 3 connected franchise mode closer to the draft, a draft theme video where I make a team entirely out of guys that are picked between rounds 4 and 7, aka day 3 of the NFL draft. I have a WAGS connected franchise mode where I'm going to make a team with all of the hottest wives. That is going to be Clickbait City. I actually think my girlfriend will feature in that video as I, you know, try to thin out the list and make the pound-for-pound best team. And I've actually got a suggestion for someone that I am including is the all-PED slash suspended slash bad boys, if you will, currently in the NFL. He was like, hey, put OJ Simpson stuff like that. I don't want to start getting into legends. We'll just go with the current guys. But today's video is out of position. So, I think I did most of these. Some of them are humorous. Some of these are realistic in terms of, you know, I'd move safeties to linebackers and linebackers to safeties and stuff like that. But I juiced everyone to the gills, pretty much. I mean, what's the fucking point of doing this with everyone that's super high overall? I will get into it when I get to the players. Some guys I didn't juice as much. Like, for example, I'd make a wide receiver corner, I'd juice him to the gills. But if I made a safety into a linebacker and you transition him, he's already like an 80 overall because they have very similar skill sets. What I would do is juice one skill set up to a 99, and that was it. So some guys you're going to see in like 97, 98s. But then you're going to see other guys that are in like the high to mid 80s because I didn't really go super crazy with them. I think this is going to be a team that will compete right away for the playoffs and a potential Super Bowl appearance. So at the quarterback position, we have a few options. First, we got Braxton Miller there. We didn't really touch. He's a 63. Julian Edelman, 76 overall. Everyone knows that he was a quarterback back in Kent State, and he will be one of our backups. Maybe I could have made him a little bit better, but we still have Julian Edelman. Then we have Terrell Pryor Sr., who was a quarterback at Ohio State. He's an 80. But the number one quarterback, we're going with the former junior college quarterback, now offensive tackle for the Philadelphia Eagles, Lane Johnson. I don't know how many people out there outside of the Eagles fan base that knew Lane Johnson actually was a college quarterback once upon a time. So, you know, obviously, maybe when you came in this video, you thought it was going to be Edelman or Pryor. But no, definitely using Lane Johnson at quarterback, to me, would be the funnest experience possible. Look at the running back position. What we got here is we made Tyreek Hill a running back just because, just imagine that speed. He'll 100% be our third down back. We also have Percy Harvin here at 86 overall. Very similar skill set to, like, he honestly will transition. If you convert him from a wide receiver to a running back, I think his overalls pretty much stay like the same. So we have him there. He's kind of a tweener coming out of college anyways. But the number one running back that we'll be using is a guy that we found out through one of my earlier live streams that we did way back a couple months ago. Some guy in the shout box or chat box said, hey, get Cordarrelle Patterson. And I probably butchered that name. Cordarrelle Patterson, and make him a running back. And I was like, you know what? Let's try it out. And then we actually put him in the Super Sim for the whole year. And he had like 1,500 yards, 17 touchdowns. It was crazy. So this is more of a previous experience. We already tried this out. So why not, you know, do a little homage to the throwbacks live streams and put Cordarrelle Patterson here. Fuck, I'll get that right eventually. At running back. At fullback, it was going to be honest. We're going Dontari Poe, full out 99. gonna be hilarious using him. I want to try to find a way to make him. You know what? Actually, I wanted to make him my kick returner on special teams, but I'd have to make him a running back. Ah, whatever. It's too many steps. It's not worth it. But yeah, we have him here at 99. Wide receiver. So we have Richard Sherman, 95. Everyone knows by now he's a wide receiver at Stanford. At least started out that way. So we decided to make him there and juice him up a little bit. We have Patrick Peterson, who I just think has the build and skill set to play wide receiver right now. He's one of those guys that can get involved in the offense for some gimmicky plays for the Cardinals. So it seemed pretty easy to make him a wide receiver. Then we put Le'Veon Bell and David Johnson here as our running backs. There's plenty of running backs I could have went with. I think, maybe someone like Theo Riddick, Aqib Talib. You could use maybe C.J. Procise. But just because they're not going to be, what was the point of me doing extra effort to put in 5 and 6? So I think we get the two best undisputed pass catching backs, I think, in the NFL in Bell and Johnson. And then we have two great corners that we convert to our receiver. At the tight end position, somebody probably thought I was going to go J.J. Watt. We're still using him in a different spot, but I decided to go with Jason Peters because much like Elaine Johnson, he was a tight end in college. He was a tight end at the University of Arkansas, went undrafted, and then developed into one hell of an offensive lineman for the Buffalo Bills and eventually the Philadelphia Eagles. Some may say he is a Hall of Famer, so we decided to put him here at the tight end spot. But speaking of J.J. Watt, we made him a left tackle, 6'5", 289 pounds. He's probably best suited to be a right tackle if he ever was to play offensive line, just because he's not over 300 pounds. But I just thought, why not? Let's put J.J. Watt here at left tackle. Left guard, we went with Vince Wilfork, 6'2", 325 pounds, incredibly strong. Got that beef, to jam up in the middle. So it seemed pretty easy for me to make Vince Wilfork one of the guards. At center, we took Total Lulz. We made it Eddie Lacy because we all know Eddie Lacy is currently struggling with weight issues. So I figured, why not just throw him here on the offensive line and utilize that weight? Big is beautiful, Eddie Lacy, and we're going to utilize you here on our offensive line. Right guy, I went with Snacks Harrison. Only a 90 overall, but I mean, how are you not going to have a guy whose nickname is Snacks be on your offensive line? 350 pounds, I think that's probably being a little bit generous. So him and Wolfork, plus with big old fat Eddie Lacy and the interior of our offensive line, that should be able to move the pile. And then at right tackle, we went with Calais Campbell because he's a monster of a man, 6'8", 300 pounds. I think he could transition very well to a right tackle. Very, very quick on his feet, has a quick first step, has the size and the strength. I think if you're doing like some crazy Pro Bowl gimmicky switch everyone else, I think he'd be one of my first picks for an offensive lineman. On the defense side of the ball, left defensive end, not a big change, but Vic Beasley is classified as an outside linebacker here in Madden. And this is a little homage back to the old Madden days where everyone, I don't know if maybe it's just my group of friends, but you always took the top outside linebackers and in-game switched them to defensive ends because it made them great. Best thing was thinking about Sean Merriman. Sean Merriman used to be the guy. He was like an 84, 85 overall linebacker for the San Diego Chargers. You make him an outside or defensive end, he'd go right up to a 99 and be actually unblockable. So that's what I did for the defensive end spot. So I went with Vic Beasley at left defensive end, and at right defensive end, I went with Aldon Smith at 91 overall. Didn't even really touch either one of these guys. I made, I think I juiced, actually, there you go. What I did, all I did was touch, I gave them all, both of them, 99 block shit. But all the other stats stayed the same. For defensive tackles, we went with big, bulkier outside linebackers. So we have Pernell McPhee, who is on the Chicago Bears, 6'3", 275 pounds. And then we have T-Sizzle, Terrell Suggs, 6'3", 265. Both these guys could technically have the build to be undersized defensive tackles in a 4-3 scheme. So I was like, let's put them here. I think that'll be pretty fun to use. Not the, they're not super overpowered. Especially T-Sizzle only up with an 85, but it will be fun to use them. Looking at outside linebacker, left outside linebacker, we went with Cam Bam Bam Chancellor, 86 overall. I think what we gave him was 99 block shed as well. He's only at an 86, but he made a pretty good transition to outside linebacker. And depending on like some team's scheme, like honestly, if Cam Chancellor went to free agency, I think there would be a couple teams out there that would be like, man, he could fit in our team as a linebacker. So that's why we have him there, especially if he, Father Time is going to catch up with him eventually, and speed will go down a little bit. So I think maybe a switch to linebacker could fit him. Just probably not with Seattle because they're set there. Middle linebacker, we went with Jay Proche, the fullback from the Houston Texans. I just made a sweet switch because look at that, 6'1", 256 pounds. He is gigantic. He's probably is debatably one of the strongest players in the NFL in terms of just like how his build, I would say. And made a pretty easy switch to make him middle linebacker. Right outside linebacker with Eric Weddle. I thought, what are the two best tackling safeties in the NFL. Maybe a potential hot take, but I thought Weddle, with his coverage skills and his tackling ability, plus he played, I could have used him anywhere. He played a little bit of running back, I believe, back in his time in Utah, so he just fits with the whole out-of-position mold, so that's why we made him one of our outside linebackers. For our corners, we went with Julio Jones, who's a 93, juice to the gills, AJ Green, 89, and Mike Evans, 87. We also have Mark Barron there, who I did have a safety, but I was like, ah, we just got to get another corner in there. So there we go. We took 2-3 superstars. We got 6'5", 6'4", 6'3", all big-time rangy guys that I really think that, you know, they can make a train. All either one of these guys, they have the skill set and athletic ability. I think they could transition to be a solid, you know, corner in the NFL just from sure athleticism and just sticking on a guy in man coverage. Looking at free safety, we made it Shaq Thompson from the Carolina Panthers. Played a little bit of safety in college. Currently classified as an outside linebacker, so that was pretty easy. And then we went with Deion Buchanan, who most people say this is like the glitch, because you straight up move him from outside linebacker without even touching him. He goes up to a 92. I don't know what I gave him. I gave him 99 pursuit was what I gave him for his thing. So now he's up at a 93. The kicker is Tim Hightower. Didn't touch him. Just made him from running back to a kicker, and he's a 76 overall. I thought that was pretty fucking hilarious. So we decided just to keep that. I don't know why his kicking stats are so high. I have no idea. I didn't really look into why it is, but I'm sure probably someone knows, and you can leave that in the comment section. And then at punter with Ben Roethlisberger. This was the only like Mutt influence card I used because I think Mutt gave him another position punter card. He does do the pooch kick from occasion, probably better than anyone else in the NFL. So we have him here as our punter. Who gonna go for kick return? Obviously, we'll have Tyreek Hill as our special teamer. Let's have him there. Third down running back. Oh, okay, we'll do that for fun. Just because it's absolute shit show. We'll get him at number two, I guess. I don't know. Do we want to have... He's only 23 over. Like, that's stupid. All right, we'll just have Tyreek Hill as a third down running back as well. There, guys, that is the out-of-position roster. And what we're going to do is, similar to all the other connected franchise modes, we're going to simulate to Week 16, and we'll play the last two games of the season, and then this team, for sure, better be in a fucking playoff run. So the last two games, plus whatever we do in the playoffs, will be the gameplay that you will see within this video. So I think this is going to be pretty overpowered. I mean, we got a pretty sick roster. And this was a video I wanted to do. I didn't really feel like recording any videos today. I'm getting kind of lackadaisical because I had a couple rebuilds already uploaded, so I haven't been working on one. I have to work on the newest one, and I've just been fucking lazy. I don't know why. Like, this is the weekend I want to, because next weekend is Super Bowl weekend for me. Like I said, this video is probably coming out a little bit later after that. Actually, when is this video coming out? I have my little upload schedule. Oh, this is actually coming out the Thursday before the Super Bowl. So, as of recording this, I'm actually only a week behind you guys. This is Thursday, the week before you guys saw this. And I need to record the rebuild that you're going to see this week, which will be the Oakland Raiders. And I need to do that this weekend. But I really want to get it done earlier in the week. And I've just fucking procrastinated the shit out of it. That in part with Overwatch released a new, like, Chinese New Year update. So I'm playing a little bit of Overwatch, which is, the hell? Oh, that was the preseason. Alright, let's sit into the midseason here. Yeah, you'll see some Overwatch gameplay. Just in the background of some videos, I think you'll see it for... Well, you've already saw it for my NFL Mock Draft 1, and I think you're going to see some Overwatch in the background of my newest Philadelphia Eagle Mock Draft, which will be coming out Saturday, Super Bowl Saturday. So Saturday, I'm trying my best to avoid double uploads. People always say, like, why I have to wait so long for these videos to come? Like, there's a big gap between when I was doing my prospect rankings. Like, you guys had to wait a bit after the quarterback, running back, wide receiver. You get to see offensive line and stuff like that. It's because double uploads are fucking horrendous. Enough people have enough problem here on YouTube when they say, like, oh, do my videos hit the sub box? My views are down. Are people seeing my videos? You guys actually getting these notifications when they come up? That's already a big enough issue. Throw in the mix double uploads when you upload two videos in one day, which has always been an issue on YouTube. I'm trying. That's like one of the things that when I met with my network that I should work at is like to try at best to avoid double uploads. It'll be a little bit different when I can do an upload during the day and then that night I can go to live stream. I think that will be just a little bit of a different dynamic to bring. But when I straight up have two double uploads, it's does take a little bit of a hit on the channel. What are we sitting at? 8-0. We're a perfect 8-0 here. Oh, shit. We're not seeing the playoffs. We'll just start going 1 week. So the double uploads kind of suck, but you will see double upload this Saturday. Few and far between, because I'm going to get you my Super Bowl prediction video, which will come earlier in the day. And then that night, I will have my Eagles mock draft. I don't know what version it is. I think it's 4.0 officially. So that would be pretty cool. Oh, we dropped our first game of the season. What else is new? Out of position. Oh, yeah. Pretty much the reason why I want to do this, I just thought, like, man, that'd be pretty fun. I kind of want to just have some fun here today. Don't want to do a super serious rebuild that I could get frustrated with. And I was just, to do a rebuild, especially the way that I do it, where I have to come up with rookies, like, you kind of need to feel a little bit creative. You need to, like, here's what I can do with the Raiders. I can take this and that. I can take A, B, and C, switch them out, and add these rookies to make an impact and stuff like that. Haven't really had that inspiration to do it, even though I think it's probably just because this week I have been recording so much draft stuff. I've done mock drafts. I just got off the tail end of, like, last weekend was when I recorded all of my prospect rankings. So I think I'm just getting a little bit overwhelmed at the moment of draft prospects, but I will get off the fucking horse here. And on Pro Bowl weekend and record, at least get all the gameplay done for the Raiders rebuild. I have no idea what I'm going to do with that. That's going to be a tough rebuild just because they have, like, so many old guys on the offensive line. It's just, I don't know. So what we're going to do here is play Week 16 and 17, as I promised, even though none of these guys are really division opponents. We're 13-1 on the year, so we're going off here. All right, let's play the moments. Let's get that Lane Johnson QB power going. So yeah, I don't think I really missed anyone, but if I did, you could probably let me know in the comment section below, even though it doesn't fucking matter one goddamn bit. This is the impromptu time where if you're just stumbling upon this video and you've yet to subscribe and my swearing hasn't really offended you enough, don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button and join us here on Beast Mode TV. I thought this video was going to be pretty popular. The more captivating my connected franchise modes are, it seems like the last one I did was the all-bus team, which is, I think, in a similar type of popularity as this one. That one got like 60,000 views, so I hope this video does well because I have no idea where my subs will be at. I want to try to get 30,000 subscribers by the time Super Bowl comes this coming Sunday. At the time this video has come out, I'm probably going to be kind of close, so I hope this video may be the popularity type of video that can get me over that edge. It was a lofty goal to get 30,000 by the Super Bowl, but who knows? Maybe we'll do it. All right. Red zone alert. All right, let's see what Lane Johnson can do. The thing that's going to be funny is that we didn't really change anyone's size, so Lane Johnson's still going to be like a monster of a man at quarterback. Oh, Jesus Christ. All right, let's do this. Lane Johnson dropping back. It's Jason Peters in the flat. Oh, my God, he's a monster. There we go. Let's keep with the slants here. Lane Johnson there. What a monster. Probably could add another. Like, I think I could have gone J.J. Watt as a tight end. I think that'll be one of the few things people may complain about. Especially because they probably get, I don't know, the Texans play. Oh, that's another thing that's probably fucked up. Don't the Texans run, as we threw the touchdown under Pat Pete? You know, the Texans run a 3-4. I totally made this defense in the mold of a 4-3. That could be something. But again, they're 13-1. The only thing that'll suck is there probably might be like a couple players that I didn't expect were going to play, like the backup middle linebacker, and I don't think T-Sizzle will have very many stats. Boom! Pat Pete makes the catch. Goes to the 4-yard line. I guarantee Lane Johnson has got some pretty absurd stats, I think. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if he wins the MVP. Lead Le'Veon Bell. Too goddamn easy. Josh Shaw didn't have a chance. But yeah, as I stated, you know, about a couple minutes ago, feel free to do your suggestion. No suggestion is too dumb for me to consider to do for this. Like I said, this is pretty dumb. This is not realistic at all. It's just something that's fun. Just shut your brain off. Where I like to do, you know, a buzzword on my channel is realistic. Occasionally, you just need to say, fuck it. That sounds like that'd be pretty goddamn fun to do. Let's scramble with Lane Johnson. That's also what we're going to do here. So no suggestion is too bad. And how the last time I did this, you guys gave me, even though I already kind of had it going, and I was going down the direction anyway, but someone came up with the all-suspended team, the bad boy team. Which I don't know when it will come out. I still have to record all that stuff. Oh, just getting his feet in. Jason Peters. Look at that. Okay. We send Richard Sherman down deep here. Jump ball to Richard Sherman. Oh, what a grab. User catch. Letting everyone know that I got the skills to pay the bills. Lane Johnson is an absolute cannon. I don't know what his junior college was either, but I was very surprised when I found that. But he usually is our security quarterback for the Eagles. So, I mean, I hope for my sake, there's never a time where the Eagles have to, look at that, great, just get rid of the ball. Eagles have to resort to the emergency quarterback, because that means my Lord and Savior Carson Wentz would have got injured. But it would be pretty amusing to see Lane Johnson come out there at quarterback. Then again, he has to stop taking his goddamn special supplements, Mexican supplements. They get him banned all the time. Oh, come on. That was good coverage. Drake Kirkpatrick with great coverage. Pat Pete. Maybe we can send Pat Pete deep. Oh, let's hit Richard Sherman there. Lane Johnson, 8 of 12, 123 yards, 2 touchdowns. Let's get touchdown 3. Let's show him why the fans chant MVP. Oh, that was horrible. Let's run it here. You know, it is fun throwing at Lane Johnson. I'm going to promise to run it a little bit more in the second half. Let's see what we can do with Cordero Patterson. Oh, Jesus. You got crushed. Let's hit the C4 special to Patterson here. Look, it's catching on. If I ever did sick t-shirts, that's what would happen. C4 special. There's not a whole lot of memes. That's another thing. Let me know memes that I've said throughout my channel. I have no idea. I know we got iAIDS is one. Kevin Pedophile is another one. C4 special. I don't know. I'm not a big meme guy, but there's been a couple memes throughout the history of my channel here. Same with the pitch again. Let's do HB strong toss. Because we are well in control. Oh, but the game's telling me it's green to this side, so we'll do that. Oh, that's Tyreek Hill. Oh. Not as fast as I thought. Look at that great punt. A 50-yard punt by Ben Roethlisberger. If I was controlling it, there would be fake punt city. Defense has forced 2 turnovers. Great for them. We'll send Sherman deep, but I think we might look for just Jason Peters across the middle. Oh, he got rocked, but he comes in with the catch. Old man Peters making the reception. Ooh. If we go on third down, maybe hit Tyreek Hill on the screen pass. I think that could be a big-time play. We'll send Le'Veon here across the middle. I don't know what the fuck, Pat Pete. I thought he was coming to him. Looks like he stumbled over his own feet. Very efficient game so far from Lane Johnson. 0 turnovers. Turnover-free ball here. Oh, cup. Someone get that. That fucking ping pong of a ball there. Come on. That was on purpose. Lane Johnson just threw it into the mix. You know, threw it into that fucking blender of players and hoping someone could come down with it. No one had the wherewithal to bring it in, though. Boom. There we go, Pat Pete. Third passing touchdown of the day to Mr. Lane Johnson. Ooh. Well, it's a victory. 28-15 wasn't, I don't know, we didn't shit on them. But we were never, at one point in that game, out of control. So big time. 80 receptions on the year for Pat Pete. Still a game in hand for us to pad and accumulate some stats. Get Jerry Rice here today. I don't think so. I don't want that. All right. Okay. Advance to the 5 week. Jam and lemon and that sugar crisp. Jesus Christ, these are body bags. Yeah, we'll just roll this. I'm gonna change the unis. We won't get any special unis. Oh, fuck. I think my food might be ready, and I do not want to stop. There's going to be a momentary unprofessional break, and there's probably going to be some eating. I don't know. Hopefully you guys don't hate me for it. But if I have to stop this when I'm eating and then re-record, or not, like, then record the second part, that means I have to render the fucking video. It's going to take, like, goddamn 4 hours. I'll try to use my best manners here. In the regular season finale against the 6-8-1 Tennessee Titans, we're 14-1. Lane Johnson has been an absolute animal for us. Closed it in there on 4,000 passing yards. We'll try our hardest to get him for that. All right, we're in the red zone. Nice. Let's go with a flood pass. Get Jason Peters in the back of the end zone. Oh, yeah, I think my food's done. My food is done. Okay. Let's go mesh. Oh, my God, he fumbled. You tell me Lane Johnson wouldn't truck over that guy? I disagree. I think for sure Lane Johnson would truck over that guy. All right, held him to a field goal. Let the computer play a lot of this game because I have to go get my food here in a second. There we go. Third down, 2 minute drill. Another touchdown. Jesus. All right, we'll pick up here in the red zone. Hit with a flanker drive. No more scramble with Lane Johnson, though. I think it's going to be best for our quarterback's health not to scramble with Lane Johnson. Oh, my God. He got tackled so hard, he didn't find his way to the end zone. Let's go screen pass. What the fuck's the flag on that? Of course there's a flag. Offside. Get that shit out of here. Alright. What the hell? Look at their lineup. What are they running? They have 7 people standing up. Okay, thanks for the easy touchdown. Pat Pete, another one. 12th touchdown of the year. He's an animal. He's feasted all year. I think we'll take over here because I think I want to get at least one field goal in just in case nothing happens. The opportunity doesn't arise in the playoffs with, oh, geez, that was a good call. With the Hightower. Hell yeah, I'm kicking that field goal. 48-yarder, Tim Hightower. Well, we got a little bit of a... Oh! Hey! There we go, Tim Hightower putting it through. Maybe we should have juiced him up a little bit because that was pretty pathetic. That was only a 48-yarder. So anytime we have to make a long field goal, we're probably going to struggle. Alright, I'm going to get my food. There's going to be no bread. I didn't die. I'm just going to run upstairs and get my food. And I should be back as the loading screen finishes. I'm back. Shout out. Big shout out. If you're looking for a fucking sponsorship, shout out to Kirkland Pizza. Costco brand pizza. Let's go. Alright. Let's sim pass this. We definitely have a first round bye. Let's be honest. Let's not kid anyone here. First round bye, for sure. I think that we just saw Lane Johnson was awarded the MVP of the league. We'll double check that to be sure. So on the year for the stats, Lane Johnson, 4,100 passing yards, 47 touchdowns, 12 interceptions. That is an MVP caliber season if I've ever seen one myself. Beast. Who said he's only a JUCO quarterback? Running the ball, Cordarrelle. Fuck. I don't think I'm ever going to get that right. Cordarrelle Patterson, 1,400 rushing yards, 8 touchdowns. Very similar to what we saw when used him way back when in the live stream. 800 yards, 8 touchdowns to Percy Harvin. Pat Pete led the team with 87 receptions, 800 yards, and 12 touchdowns. Jason Peters, 7 receptions, 650 yards, 6 touchdowns. Richard Sherman, 936 yards, 12 touchdowns. Le'Veon Bell, 1,100 yards and 9 touchdowns. Patterson with almost 400 yards and 5. Not too shabby. Blocking, Jesus, girl, not whole much there. On the defensive side of the ball, Jay Prosh. 131 tackles, 100 tackles for Mr. Dayon Buchanan. On the sacks front, we got 10.5 from Alden Smith, 8.5 for Vic Beasley, 8.5 from Pernell McPhee. And on the interception front, 5 picks for Julio Jones, 4 for Green, 4 for Prosh, 3 for Shaq Thompson, 2 for Eric Weddle, and a bunch of guys had 1. But let's just take a look here at the yearly awards. The big one. The MVP went to Lane Johnson, undisputed. Obviously the greatest quarterback to ever live, which is very nice. So let's jump right in to our playoff matchup in the divisional round against the Cincinnati Bengals, it looked like. All right. The 15-1 Houston Texans going up against the lowly, probably going to be one and done if their franchise history lead you to believe anything, Cincinnati Bengals. Let's have a little bite of little nom here of pizza. Not that good. I've had better Kirkland pizzas. Friggin' shout out to Darrow's Arrows for buying the cheapest pizza you can fucking buy there. I know you can get the one with bacon, motherfucker. We got pepperoni only and burn the roof of my mouth. That's bullshit. That's a work hazard. I'm finna run a train on the Bengals here just for this shit pizza, that one bite of pizza I had. All right. Big first quarter drive. We will take this one over. Oh, great. Now my girlfriend's coming over. And now she's gonna huff and puff if she gets here before, if I don't finish this video. Jesus Christ. See, this is what happens when you do spur-of-the-moment recordings, because then you just forget that you had a pizza in the oven, you forget that you have other obligations with other people in your life. Oh. Well, hopefully it will be at least in the only one game for her to sit. And now my batteries are low on my controller? The fuck, man? So unprepared. But Jason Peters is prepared. Where the fuck is my charger? Oh, there we go. Okay. Let's do this. Oh, and then the fucking neighborhood cat is upstairs and I can't go see him because I'm recording. This is officially the worst recording I've ever done. Oh. Woe is me. Great gain there, though. Lane Johnson, 2-2, 43 yards. An absolute rocket. He's a rocket man. Oh, there we go. Let's just hope I don't get interrupted here telling me that the cat's out there and I gotta go see him. Because I'm trying to do some work here in the red zone. Come on, Pat Pete. Oh, I don't like any of that. Oh, wow. That should have been intercepted. Didn't mean to hit Y. My mind is just bamboozled right now. Get your fucking head in the game, C4. I know your mouth's burnt a little bit, especially the roof. Maybe a little bit of the tip of your tongue because that fucking scalding hot average Kirkland pizza. But you need to fucking do this one. You got to win the Super Bowl here. You have MVP Lane Johnson. You got a freak tight end like Jason Peters. You got to win this. You got to do this for the boys. Okay. Boom, wide open. Le'Veon Bell with the touchdown. Go ahead, touchdown. In front of the home fans at whatever the fuck this stadium's called. I have no idea. Fourth down, 32 yards. Let's bring out Tim Hightower. That's not, I think oh shit. They're gonna have to go through us in Houston, and we're in a dome, so it should make the kicking, which is something I'm a little bit worried about, as good as it possibly could be. I don't know, I'm not for sure if we were the number one seed, but I'm pretty sure we were the number one seed. That being said, we can't overlook Cincinnati. Oh my god, at least they're not going for the interception, they're going for the blocks. The pass deflections, you know? Oh yeah, I'll bring out whatever, Hightower. Boom. Goddamn iron leg on him. Well, you've heard of an iron lung? You got an iron leg. Ooh, that's a turnover. Tie ball game. We cannot be one and done. I'm gonna have another bite of pizza here, see if it got any better. Well, I'll give you guys a quick review. Not better. The crust is shit. It's like a fucking rubbery crust. You know, you guys are also getting not only out of position kick to franchise mode, but a review of the Kirkland Pack of Four pepperoni pizza. Could be better. Expectations. Kirkland is a phenomenal brand, you know. Respect the Kirkland brand, but this pizza is just, I think it said premium pizza on the box. No. This is the worst pizza I've ever had from a Costco store. Just walking right into the sack. Y'all know Lane Johnson got that cannon. Just someone beat their man down deep. He'll find you. Lead him on the inside. There we go. Pat Pete, burn a timeout. We'll go strong flood. Even though it's not really taking a shot to the end zone, we're going to find someone in the middle of the field. Hey, shout out to the Bengals. They're making it tough on us. Chase Pierce gets out of bounds because he knows. He's well aware of his situation on where he's on the field. Do-do-do-do-do. All right. All right, we'll get one shot for the end zone. It doesn't work. We'll kick that field goal. Flanker drive, maybe. Get Pat Pete. Oh, that did not work. Oh, timeout, 1 second left. Let's bring out Tim Hightower. And boom. It's good. 3-point lead. Definitely not, ideal. Definitely not the best thing we could have, but it could be worse. Oh, shit. You know who's here, guys. Just wait for it. It's going to be the most. Oh, Jesus, we ain't lose. Oh, we got a chance. Get ready for the most louding. I'm not, she's going to try to be quiet, but it's going to be so fucking loud. Guess you wait, but here we go. Moment of truth. Oh, my fuck! Dunlop is feasting on us. Four, three sacks right now. What is Eddie Lacy thinking? We have no timeouts. This is not looking good. Oh, Jesus. Make that nice catch. I told everyone that's going to be about really, really loud here in a second, because no matter how quiet you try to be, it's going to be just absurdly loud. But it's looking like we're going to fucking lose one and done here, and it's going to be done in a second.
I can't close that.
Whatever. Oh. Was that Dunlap again? All right, 4th and 31. I think we're going to have to make some magic here. I guess we overlooked the Cincinnati Bengals. We're used to them. Can you not make any noise, please, Kate? Oh, every game's over. You came in, killed the fucking mojo in the room.
You were 4th and 31.
Yeah, before it was before that. We had the final drive when you came in. I knew you were in the house. My mind's not right. My brother made some pizza. It's not as good as I thought it was. It burnt the roof of my mouth while I was trying to be quiet, not chew with my mouth open. Oh, man. Just flabbergasted. So I wish I could have done a little bit better here, guys, but I hope you did enjoy this out-of-position connected franchise mode. Utterly a failure. Thought, you know, the fact that we went 15-1 in the season and we lost in our first playoff game. I didn't know we were the Dallas Cowboys here. I thought we were the Houston Texans, but we Dallas Cowboyed it. We choked. But let me know what you guys think for suggestions of different connected franchise modes we can do. If this is your first time stopping by, don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button. If you like the video, maybe we can get 69 likes at least and probably 5 dislikes. That'd be a pretty cool goal to reach. And until next time, it's your boy C4 saying peace out in this.